Hello friends and welcome back to another video from my YouTube channel, that is Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. So your friend Vipin Sharma is currently available on India's largest learning platform, that is Unacademy. So you can follow me on Unacademy by clicking on the link given in the description below, as well as you can watch all my lectures made on Unacademy's platform. You can also download the Unacademy's learning app from Google Play Store for better learning experience. Aaj hum baat karenge about some terminology, right? Some terms and some symbols which are related to the genetics, because after this video, we are going to start different kind of crosses. Before that, we have to understand some basic terms which will help us to make all the crosses and Punnett squares very, very effectively. So, what is T and T? There are different kind of contrasting characters in ke baare mein hum baat kar chuke hain. So, we have talked about 7 pair of contrasting characters, right? Let's say the first one is plant's height. So, if we take height as the character, it will have two traits, okay? The first one is going to be tall and the second one is going to be dwarf, but they should not be denoted with different alphabets, right? This is not like that T or D or D. It cannot be denoted like this because we have to represent a relationship between them. Hum baat kar chuke hain about the dominant and recessive relationship between these traits or these alleles. So, if we want to show them as dominant and as recessive, we need to choose a single alphabet. In the case of height, we will choose the dominant character, that is tall. So, the dominant will be denoted as T and the recessive will be denoted as T. There is same alphabet, but the one is going to be in the upper case and the second one or the recessive one is going to be in the lower case. Right? If we will talk about the color of seeds, let's say color of seed, then there are two type of traits right now. What are those traits? The dominant one is going to be the yellow and the recessive one is going to be green. So if the dominant one is represented by yellow, that is capital Y, then the recessive one must be represented by the same alphabet Y, but in lowercase. So, ये एक basic method है crosses को आसानी से बनाने का, जिससे confusion create ना हो. So, to avoid confusion, the dominant as well as the recessive form are shown or are symbolized with the help of same alphabet but in different styles, right? The one is going to be, the dominant one is going to be in the upper case and the, you know, recessive one is going to be in the lower case. So, there are 7 contrasting characters. They can be different, they can be, you know, shown by different alphabets, and those alphabets will represent both of the situations, that is dominant and recessive. Ek jo hoga dominant wala, wo hoga upper case mein, jo recessive wala hoga har case mein, wo hoga lower case mein. Aur hum koi bhi alphabet le sakte hain, lekin most probably jo hum koshish karte hain ki jo trait ka naam hai dominant wale ka, us hisab se lete hain. For example, in this case, yellow seeds are dominant over green, so yellow's first letter, that is Y, is taken. In tall, the T is taken because tall word starts from T, and dwarf, there is no role of dwarf because it is recessive. So small T is taken, which is derived from the tall itself. Okay? So is tarike se hum symbolize karte hain in cheezon ko in genetics. Right? There is going to be the same alphabet which is used in two styles to, you know, give an overview about the dominant and recessive things. After that, what is homozygous? Okay, what is homozygous? So, we know very well that how progeny is formed. The progeny is formed by the combination of genes. Okay, so let's say this is the parent's gene. This is coming from father, only one gene. And this is coming from mother. So, it will combine to form another progeny. And in this case, both the alleles are same. That is capital T, capital T. In the next case, it can be small t, small t. When both of these factors are same, it means that the condition is homozygous. Homo means same. So it does not matter whether it is going to be capital T or small t. Lekin agar dono same hai, use hum homozygous bolenge. Uske baad pura agar hume isko define karna hai acche se, to hum bolenge homozygous dominant. Because both of these are dominant, so the overall expression is also going to be dominant. So this is the homozygous dominant trait. And when we talk about this one, this is going to be the homozygous recessive trait. Right? Just opposite to that, there is another situation known as heterozygous. Now, what is heterozygous? When the combination of two different factors is present, such as capital T, small t, this is going to be the only one situation, right? In this case, do thi, capital T is also homozygous, small t is also homozygous. But capital T, small t is heterozygous because both of these factors are different. The overall expression will be tall. The overall expression is going to be dominant, but we call it heterozygous. So what is the overall expression? It is heterozygous dominant. And why it is heterozygous dominant, not recessive? उसके बारे में हम बात कर लेते हैं, that what is the meaning of dominant recessive relationship. In the last lecture we have talked about it, but let's revise once more so that it can be much betterly seen, okay, in a much better way. So क्या था यहाँ पर? If there is a dominant trait, right? So it is seen in the plant. And if there is a recessive trait, it is also seen easily in the plant. For example, the tall plants are going to be about 7 feet and the dwarf plant are going to be about 0.5 to 1 feet or 1.5 feet. There is no longer height than this. Okay, so they can be easily distinguished on the basis of their height. So when there is pure tall plant, it is going to be of very long height. Pure short or pure dwarf plant is going to be of very small height. And जब ये वाला केस प्रेजेंट होता है ना, तो हाइट बहुत ज्यादा होती है. दिस केस रिप्रेजेंट्स द सेम हाइट एज प्योर टॉल प्लांट बिकॉज इन दिस केस द कैपिटल टी मास्क द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ स्मॉल टी. कहने का मतलब है, देखो एक केस अज्यूम करते हैं कि कैपिटल टी इज अ डाकू एंड स्मॉल टी इज अ बच्चा जिसको किडनैप करना होता है. सो ओमनी वैन लेके आता है और उसके ऊपर पर्दा डाल देता है. सो नाउ हु इज डोमिनेटिंग? द कैपिटल टी इज डोमिनेटिंग और स्मॉल टी जो बच्चा है वो पूरे तरीके से किडनैप हो चुका है. उसका अब कोई रोल नहीं है एक्सप्रेशन में, उसे मास्क कर दिया गया है. ओमनी में डाल के उसके मुंह पे बोरी बोरी ढक दी गई है, अब उसका कोई रोल नहीं है. सो कैपिटल टी विल एक्सप्रेस इटसेल्फ. एंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग और व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ डोमिनेंट एंड रिसेसिव? द कैरेक्टर और द ट्रेट, if you talk specifically and correctly, the trait that used to express itself in the F1 generation, we will talk about the F1 generation, it is known as the filial first generation. अपने आप को जो express कर पाता है, that is the dominant. In the most simplest way, in the presence of two different factors, the one that is going to express itself is the dominant, the second one जिसकी activity mask हो चुकी है is the recessive. In this case and in most of the cases, the dominant one, okay, if it is present with the recessive one, the dominant will dominate and the recessive will not be expressing that much, right? So the overall expression is of the dominating trait, right? So jab to alag alag tarike ke jo factors present hote hain, unme se jo ek express kar deta hai, that is known as the dominant. Jo express nahi kar pata hai, jo bechara kidnap ho gaya hai, that is the recessive. So this is the relationship between dominant and recessive traits, right? आगे आप क्रॉसेस करते जाएंगे, धीरे धीरे कंसेप्ट जो है क्लियर होते जाएंगे. यहीं पे कुछ क्लियर नहीं होने वाला, यहाँ पे सिर्फ आपको डेफिनेशन याद हो जाएंगे. लेकिन आगे जैसे हम बढ़ेंगे टाइम के साथ साथ, जैसे हम क्रॉसेस करने लग जाएंगे और उन क्रॉसेस में आपको धीरे धीरे समझ में आने लग जाएगा क्रॉसेस करते टाइम, एट द टाइम ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ गैमेट्स, दैट व्हाट इज एक्चुअली गोइंग ऑन. एंड एट दैट टाइम यू विल रियलाइज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ ऑल दीज वर्ड्स. राइट नाउ यू जस्ट हैव टू मेमोराइज द डेफिनेशन. There is no practical application in this particular lecture. But after that, when you will be making crosses, when you will be doing different kind of things in the chapter, when you will proceed in the chapter, toh aapko pata lagega these are of very high importance in this chapter. Okay? So, abhi ke liye sirf definition kar lete hain. The one, okay, in heterozygous condition, the one that expresses itself is the dominant, that does not expresses is the recessive. Okay? Then phenotype and genotype. The name tells about itself. Okay, खुद ही सब कुछ बताता है. Geno means the genetic material. It is related to the genetic material, right? And pheno simply means P or H. It simply related to the physical appearance. So PH simply means Phenotype is related to the physical appearance. So what is going to be the appearance of plant? That is the phenotypic character, जो कि हम बाहर से देख के बता सकते हैं. Okay? For example, tallness. So if you will look at a tall plant, so I can indicate that yes, this is a tall plant. Its phenotype is tall. But what is genotype? We have to go inside the plant to have a look at the genotype. In case of short plant, the genotype is, you know, हम बता सकते हैं. It can be guessed in this case. How? Because there is only one case in which the short plant will come. In what case? When both the factors are going to be small t. So if we look at a small plant, at a dwarf plant, we can say that yes, it is a small plant. So its phenotype is small, right? Its phenotype is short plant. It is of short height. And its genotype is going to be TT. Okay? What is its genetic component? Genetic, उसका जो component होगा वो होगा small t, क्योंकि in that particular case only it can be a short plant. So the genetic component of any plant for any character is the genotype, and the physical characters that are developed by that genotype are known as phenotype. So PH simply means physical character and GEN simply means the genetic component. So there is nothing to ponder about it. कुछ ऐसी बड़ी बात नहीं है, नाम ही सब कुछ है. So now it creates a little bit confusion. When we talk about a tall plant, let's say I am pointing toward a tall plant that yes, it is a tall plant. So I am guessing the phenotype very very correctly that it is a tall plant. But in tall plant there is two cases. TT, capital T is dominant, so obviously it is going to be tall. But T and small t, in which T will mask the expression of small t, will also be dominant. Okay? So therefore it is also going to be tall. So for genotype, I have to make some crosses. Okay? You don't have to study the genetic material in depth to find out whether it is small t or capital T. There are some very basic general crosses. And by performing those crosses, such as back crosses, test crosses, you can easily identify the genotype of parent. कि क्या था, और ये भी हम सीखेंगे. These are very interesting crosses, so that अगर आपको पहले का भी कुछ नहीं पता, so आप parent का भी पता लगा सकते हैं with the help of these crosses. So वहाँ पर जो है, this is also going to be tall, this is also going to be tall, having same phenotype but different genetic component. This is capital T, this is capital T small t. So it does not mean that phenotype and genotype are always same, right? More than one genotype can have the same phenotype. So these are some basic terms which are very very important to understand the concepts of genetics. From the next lecture we are going to start monohybrid cross, that is why taking only one character in the consideration. After that dihybrid cross, then monohybrid test cross, back cross, dihybrid test cross, back cross, then polygenic inheritance, multiple allelism, pleiotropy. There are many topics, many interesting topics. It will take a little bit time if you will make 3-4 lectures in a day, but it will be very very interesting because it is an important chapter. Kafi questions aate hain cross based or disease based, jo questions aate hain wo sare yahi se puche jate hain. So it is equally important as the molecular basis of inheritance. So you cannot neglect this chapter. If you will complete the whole unit, that is evolution, principles of inheritance and variation, and molecular basis of inheritance, you are going to secure more than 40 questions correct in the NEET examination. That is for sure, because the data tells that there are more than 10 questions asked every year from all these units. Just from 3 chapters, more than 10-12 questions are asked. So this is very important unit, and sometimes there are more than 10 questions, that is 18-19 questions are also asked from genetics and evolution. So बहुत ज़्यादा important है. आराम आराम से पढ़ेंगे, समझते हुए पढ़ेंगे. Concepts का clear होना बहुत ज़रूरी है, practice भी करेंगे. So अगर आपको अच्छी लगी वीडियो, then hit like button. और अगर समझ में आता है कुछ तो बताइए और सब्सक्राइब कीजिए. अगर समझ में नहीं आता है तो जो सुधार करने हैं मुझे, वो मुझे कमेंट बॉक्स में बताइए. थैंक यू सो मच. स्टे ट्यून्ड. बेस्ट ऑफ लक.